There are a thousand ways to develop new startup features or even an entire digital product. Sometimes it can take just a few hours, sometimes a few months. In today's episode, I'm going to talk about the process to transform new features ideas or new startup ideas into an actionable plan. And I'm also going to talk about how to challenge developers to find the shortest path to reach your product goals. Hi, I'm Amaury, founder and CEO at My CTO Friend, where founders come to learn how to build their tech startup. And with this Startup Snack series available on both podcast and YouTube, we want to share the essential to make it easier for you to build your tech startup. And I was recently invited to a growing startup to analyze the way they organize their development. And what is great is that this startup already has a product, a few developers, and a product manager. But when it comes to find solution, they have the same problem as bootstrapping startups who don't even have developer yet. They don't know what's the best path to develop something new. So let's analyze together what's the process to move from an idea to a technology and then to a real product and to a real feature. First off, everything starts from that idea that you got maybe, I don't know, in the shower or when you were jogging. That's usually outside of the office that we get the best ideas. And if you're a startup, just in case you are not aware of it, then the management methodology you should use is, of course, the Agile Scrum methodology. With this methodology, new ideas are transformed into what we call stories, which goes into the ID box called the backlog. Most of the time, people focus on prioritizing this backlog according to what's the most important for the clients and how much each feature will cost to develop. But what is often underrated by developers is the possibility to find better solution. And most of the time, developers do things the exact same way, project after project, reusing the same technologies they already mastered. But in some cases, this is a biased decision, and this can lead to use way more resources than required, and sometimes to build software that will require a rebuild after a few months. So to avoid that problem, we need to challenge developers, and there are different ways. In developers' team, what in an organization, I would say, in a small organization, we talk about startup, right? We usually organize what we call poker scrum. That's a small game where we refine all the features that are in the backlog, the ID box, and each developer can estimate how much time each feature could cost. And then they can debate on the best and most effective way to develop them. The goal is to push developers to challenge each other, to see if they can, by just combining their knowledge, they can find shorter path. And that's what we do for startups, for small features in the meeting that we call the backlog refinement. But sometimes tasks are bigger than others, right? And for that, we cannot evaluate them in 1 or 2 minutes. So if that's the case, we just list them and then we organize a specific meeting for software architecture to really analyze and brainstorm on how we can develop these type of features. And usually before this type of meeting, we attribute the big features to one developer to do a bit of research on what would be the solution available already to develop that solution. So this meeting is most of the time required as soon as we have big features in the pipe, in the backlog. Now, if you are outsourcing, if you are a bootstrapping startup or just getting started, maybe you don't even have developers yet. First, what you need to remember is that no one has all the answers. So before to develop the very first version of your product, you should consider several options for the technologies. Of course, based on the type of product you want to create. Maybe one language or framework will be better than others for your project. For example, if you consider developing a mobile application, maybe you could use React Native or Flutter, or maybe native development or no-code technologies. So don't work just with your brother-in-law because you know that his company can develop what you need. compare not only people or agencies, but above all, technologies. Because some will be better than others, some will be more scalable than others, and some will just be faster to develop. The best process to make the right decision is first to have some clear specifications for the very first version of your product. Keep it very, very simple. Keep it small. The minimum viable product, the MVP. Secondly, to share it with few providers. And third, if possible, to get some advice from a CTO friend, a CTO advisor, someone that has enough startup experience to really lead you towards the best technology for your project without being biased with his experience or with his own interests. Basically, don't ask a provider which technology to use. It's kind of like if we will organize, in the end, a poker scrum with different providers, taking into consideration not only the price, but above all, what technical solution they suggest versus the desired product. So in conclusion, as a startup, we often use the Agile Scrum methodology. And in this methodology, we have a backlog refinement process, which consists to analyze each features after another. Sometimes it's relevant to play the poker scrum during that meeting to identify shortest path. And to be efficient, if you have some developers, be sure they prepare that meeting before the meeting by analyzing the features beforehand. And organizing technical brainstorming for large features, which require a lot of analysis. Now, if you are just getting started with maybe no developers yet, or maybe even no providers yet, then work on your first version of your specifications. And if you can, get a CTO friend to help you decide which technology you should consider for your project. Of course, you get the word CTO friend. That's our role if, of course, you want to work with us. And third, challenge few providers, asking them not only a quotation, but above all, how they will implement a said technology and how this technology will evolve over time. If you enjoy learning with us and want to see more, consider subscribing. Help us spread the word by hitting the like button or by sharing with your entrepreneur friends. Now, if you have any question and want to suggest a topic, feel free to comment down below, or you can also check out our website to learn more about our program and how you can join.